multiplied by 4 factorial, multiplied by 3 factorial. But that's not the case here. The case is basically 9 factorial divided by the whole thing on the bottom. So to make the whole thing on the bottom, to make sure your calculator know what you want to do, you have to put the parentheses around the denominator, okay? And the only reason why we do this thing here is we have repeated item, okay? Meaning we have repeated set of item. If we were to have this in class, we would go over that the word Mississippi, right? Mississippi, M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I, which is again, the word Mississippi have repeated letter. How many way can we form the word without the repeated letter, right? So distinguish, which is again, we're only doing this if they have some group of item are the same. Okay, so again, basically you take the total item divided each in the set of item, factorial of each kind. Okay. So again, in the center of this thing here, if you type this in your calculator, you should have 1260, meaning there are 1260 different ways that you can send the flag up and they don't have any repeated color. Okay. Like I say, this thing here is on your on Alex, and that's why I did not go last time, go over it last time. So I go over here so that you guys can see how to type it in your calculator or what to do with those. Okay. Let's take a look at question before number 9. Number 10, if you take a look at number 10, this is what they ask you is, in how many ways can a committee of 3 men and 4 women can be formed from a group of 8 men and 9 women, right? So looking at this thing here, which is if you look at this item, before we can attack this thing here, you have to ask yourself is, does the group of people you're choosing, does the order matter? No, right? Do they ask us to put them in rank, which is you say no. Do they give us any specific title, which is as you can see, also no, right? Because we don't have any of those items, everybody see that this thing here is a combination problem because the order does not matter, right? So there is no order involved, which is this is a combination problem. It's just that if you do this on your homework or on your material, looking at this thing here, reminder that we have multiple item, right? We have multiple category. So again, because we have a multiple category, we have to do each category by itself, which is again, we have 8 men and we need to choose 3 of them, right? And then we have 9 women and we need to choose 4 of them. Right, we have to do the men by themselves and the woman by themselves, and at the end we have to use the fundamental counting principle and take the 2 number and multiply them together. Yeah, and again, the one thing that I saw, or the one thing that I know that a lot of people make a mistake is they mix and mash the item. Make sure that you isolate the man with the man, which is instead of say AC3. A lot of students put AC4 and 9C3. So again, don't mix the man with the woman or woman with the man in terms of the number. Okay. So that's the one careless mistake I know a lot of students have, and that's where the problem come in. But again, this thing here, because the order doesn't matter, that's why we use a combination. Because we have a multiple item or multiple category, that's why we have to do each category by themselves and then multiply them at the end, which is this is your combination problem with multiple category. So question with number 9 or number 8, number 9 or number 10 here. So if you don't have question, they move to or the last, no, the second half of chapter 10 is probability, which is again, looking at this thing here, in the beginning, they just want to refresh yourself in terms of what does this item mean? What does probability of B slash A? And again, the key thing in here is if you see this item, it should remind you something, which is again, if you see this slash, a vertical line here, what does that tell us? And hopefully you gotta remember that that slash, that vertical line tell you that this is A conditional probability, right? Rumors, they ask you find the probability of B given A have already occurred, which is this is a conditional probability. And as you will see, we will deal with a conditional probability in a bit, right? The other thing is, again, this is just a critical thinking question, right? They ask you if two events are mutually exclusive, then the probability of both A and B occur is what, right? So what do we have, which is, again, what is mutually exclusive event, right? So hopefully you guys remember that mutually exclusive event is when the two items have nothing in common, right? So again, probability of A and B, which is if the two items, if they are mutually exclusive, meaning they do not have anything in common, and if they don't have anything in common, what is the probability of A and B happen at the same time? Which is, hopefully you guys say that, zero. Why zero? Because again, think about this thing here. If I have a dice and I roll the dice one time, right? What is the probability of number three and number four happen at the same time? If I roll the dice one time, there is no way number three and number four happen at the same time, right? They cannot appear at the same time. So mutually exclusive event means the two items does not have anything in common. And if they don't have anything in common, the probability that the two items appear at the same time will be zero because they don't have anything in common, okay? So the other thing they have is, you know, they just want to, you know, kind of connect the two and so that you can see that the two and are kind of the same and different in terms of this thing here. So they ask you if two events are independent, then the probability of both happen, probability of A and B, what will be the case? So the difference between mutually exclusive is, again, you only do one item. The independent and the dependent is you do multiple item, right? So if you remember this thing here, what is the probability of both of them happen, which is, again, both of them happen is you take the probability of the first one, multiply to the probability of the second one. And again, why is this the item? Because they are independent. The probability of the first one does not affect the probability of the second one, which is, again, this one here, they just want to go back and refresh you on your formula wise, right? So again, mutually exclusive, they don't have anything in common. Independent, the first probability do not affect the second probability. And again, they ask you to see if you can remember this formula, the general formula for probability of A or B, which is the word or, right? So what is the formula for the word or, which is hopefully you guys remember that to find the probability of A or B, you find the first probability plus the second probability minus what they have in common, which is A and B, right? And the other one is probability of A and B, which is, again, the general form is probability of A times probability of B given A already occurred. Again, this item here, if they are independent, then again, you only use probability of B because it's the same as before in the case. But again, looking at this thing here, they only want to refresh or remind you of what the formula is. I have to check. I will double check to see if they provide you any formula. I will let you know in terms of those. I don't know if on the final exam they allow you any formula. Let me double check on that, and I will let you guys know once I find out. But again, right now when you study, make sure to study as if they don't give you the formula, as if you have to remember the formula. Okay? So let's take a look at this next item we have here, which is, again, this one here is, again, 10.4 in a sense. Suppose the 12-sided dice is tossed one and the number is observed. Determine the sample space associated with this experiment. So look at this thing here. I have the dice.